We want to get right to our breaking news, though. Jim Sciutto, Evan Perez, and Athena Jones will join us. CNN has learned new information about the ongoing investigation into allegations raised in a collection of memos created by a former British intelligence officer for political opponents of then-candidate Donald Trump. Jim Sciutto and Evan Perez have been working on that story for us. So, Jim, what have investigators learned?
Don, for the first time, U.S. investigators telling CNN that they have corroborated some of the communications detailed in that 35-page dossier compiled by that former British MI6 agent. CNN was first to report last month that then-President-elect Donald Trump and President Barack Obama were briefed on the existence of the memos prior to the inauguration. Until now, U.S. officials have said that none of the content or allegations have been verified. But now, multiple current and former U.S. law enforcement and intelligence officials tell CNN that intelligence intercepts of foreign nationals confirmed that some of the conversations described in that dossier took place between the same individuals on the same days and from the same locations as detailed in the dossier. We should be clear that CNN has not confirmed the content of the calls or whether any of the content relates to then-candidate Trump. And none of this newly learned information relates, I should make clear, to the salacious allegations contained in the dossier. The corroboration, though, is based on intercepted communications, and that's given U.S. intelligence and law enforcement, quote, greater confidence in the credibility of some aspects of the dossier as they continue to actively investigate its contents, these sources say. Reached for comment this afternoon, White House spokesman Sean Spicer said the following, and I quote, "We continue to be disgusted by CNN's fake news reporting. We also reached out to the FBI, the Department of Justice, the CIA, the Office of the Director of National Intelligence, and they all, Don, had no comment."
Interesting, Jim. I want to go to Evan Perez now. Evan, what is the U.S. investigators? What have they corroborated?
Well, Don, when investigators first started to look at this dossier, they were trying to see whether there was any truth to these allegations that the Russians were trying to seek compromising information on President Donald Trump. To start, investigators looked at information that they could verify easily to essentially to give them a sense of the credibility of the author, who they already had known that was someone that they were familiar with and someone who had credible sources. Now, the dossier details about a dozen conversations between senior Russian officials and other Russian individuals, so that was one starting point. One thing that the U.S. Already has is a collection of foreign call intercepts. So they use that information to seek to verify some of the alleged conversations described in the dossier. Now, U.S. intelligence officials emphasize that the conversations that they have now verified were solely between foreign nationals, including those in or tied to the Russian government, and that were intercepted during routine intelligence gathering. But some of these individuals involved in the intercepted communications were already known to the U.S. intelligence community as being heavily involved in collecting information that was damaging to Hillary Clinton and helpful to Donald Trump. Now, sources who talked to us would not confirm which specific conversations were intercepted or the content of those discussions due to the classified nature of the U.S. intelligence collection programs.
Mm-hmm. Jim Sciutto, I have another question for you. While the sources say there is confirmation of some of the conversations happening, there's still a lot that U.S. investigators cannot verify as being true.
No question, Donna, and we've been very clear from the beginning in our reporting what has been confirmed, what hasn't. So as we said, one of the officials stressed to CNN that they have not corroborated, and quote, the more salacious things alleged in the dossier, and I'll remind our viewers that CNN has not reported any of those salacious allegations. However, when we first reported the story, U.S. intelligence and law enforcement officials had told us that they could not verify any parts of the memos. They're now saying differently. They're saying that they have corroborated some of these communications. None of the officials we spoke to for this story would comment or confirm that they have proof of any of the alleged conversations or meetings between Russian officials, and this is key, U.S. citizens, including associates of then-candidate Donald Trump. Officials who spoke to CNN for the story cautioned they have not yet reached any final judgment on whether the Russian government has any compromising information about the president. President Trump and his staff, as you know, Don, have repeatedly dismissed the entire dossier as, in their words, phony.
Yeah, they have. I want to bring Evan back in because I understand, Evan, that the White House just reached out to you again. What did they say?
Oh, they did, Don. Well, Sean Spicer did call us back to emphasize his extreme displeasure with this story. He said, quote, it is about time that CNN focused on the success that the president has had bringing jobs, back jobs, protecting the nation, and strengthening relationships with Japan and other nations. The president won the election because of his vision and message for the nation. That's what he said, Don.
Yeah, I'm not sure what that has to do with this reporting, but I'm glad that he called you back. At least, Athena, there's other breaking news tonight on Donald